I don't know you.
Tina, we don't call ourselves strong. We just avoid. We know the foundation we have been built on. We know that how we should behave ourselves. We know that we cannot tamper with that beam. And you don't. There are a lot of cars that are driving past at home. Don't just waste time and stand in the window. At the window looking for cars.
This one is beautiful.
I don't concentrate on that. I've got my own business in the house. Talking about building upon the solid foundation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, unless one builds his character on the rock. Because Jesus also gave us an illustration of the rock. He said in the very same place,
Palestine,
there are rocks. Solid foundation of God's building on the rock, which is the solid foundation of God's word.
She
will be surely swept away by the currents of this nation. One of the builders in the parable is one who is a thoughtful man. Who deliberately plans his house with the eye to the future. The problem, Mazana, is here.
Our problem
is that we can all be building, but a thoughtful man deliberately plans. How am I going to build this house for this house to last the test of time? The other is a thoughtless man who casually builds in the easiest way. And the one is earnest, the other is content with a careless and unexamined life. See, since when I'm telling you,
I'm saved, I love the Lord.
But I don't
talk a lot about me being saved.
And I just want you to give me space. Listen to me very carefully. Upper, we are in fellowship.
Here we've got a fellowship.
Everybody is accountable to somebody. We are accountable to God. God has given us a responsibility of making sure that we build one another in the love of God.
Amen.
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 Amen. We need to be doing that. That is why I had an article on the letters in our newspaper yesterday. Around the issue of circumcision. I'm just tired of going to TBN and talking and opening up the topics, talking about this. And I was giving them, because it's not the first time I was talking about that. And I said
that
the issue, I mean, does circumcision really make a man? And the answer is no. There's no cutting of the foreskin that will ever make a man. That's another foundation on this one. We have built a wrong foundation for our young boys. To say you go to the bush for a week or two and after that you are a man. That's nonsense. I don't care who says what.
Nonsense.
That is why we are losing young men in our province.
A province in it.
It's so funny. That's a wrong foundation for the men of this province. Who call themselves men. Coming out of the bush smoking
dark.
Involved in drugs. What kind of a foundation are we trying to build this province for?
The foundation is an NSC province.
So does it really make a man?
Make a man?
The answer is no.
There's absolutely no cutting of a foreskin will ever, even in the olden days.
Because
Shaka stopped it.
Did they
cease to be men? It was because of something that was reasonable and constructive. Because they were faced with wars.
And
this thing was wasting time.
And
because in those days, people would spend 6 months in the bush. They had to stop the scholar because, you know, I'm presenting, because of the boys in Pondoland who were quarreling and stabbing one another because of the issue of Ulwaluk.
Circumcision.
What's that? Is that really a man? Trying to build a nation with a bunch of people who come out of the bush smoking,
drinking.
The tick. It's time that Eastern Cape has got to make to change, otherwise the residents, economically and otherwise. Does it really make a man?
It means it not alone.
Responsibility, that's what makes a man. Responsible person. See, what does a man in the house? Does it matter whether that man has not cut his foreskin? Women, even the mother of that young boy. When the snakes come in. Then mama says, he looks for a male figure.
So
that's a snake.
Because
he understands that there's a responsibility attached to this person.
Is this young boy going to say, Baba,
I can't cut your foreskin? I saw
not yet cut foreskin. No.
I'm closing. Now I'm closing. The flood. Oh, the other is a thoughtless man who casually builds in the easiest way. The one is earnest. The other is content with a careless and unexamined life. And the latter seems to avoid the hard work of digging deep to ensure a strong foundation, and also takes a short range of view, He avoids the digging up until he touches the rock. It's not enough to be saved as long as you have not touched the rock. Up until it's a secure circle, your building is attached to the rock. It won't be enough. Don't be lazy. Dig. No wonder God spoke to us.
Yeah,
says the burning bush minister has not started building up.
He's
still building down. Because he's trying to anchor the foundation. Your relationship must be attached to the rock. Everything that you do, your business, the rock, your education, the rock, everything that you do, the rock.
If your thing is not connected,
nevertheless, the solid foundation still stands. That whoever builds must make sure that he builds upon the right foundation. If you build upon a sandwich walk, you can be excited. You can raise up your hands. You can sing with us. But the devil knows that your building is hanging. You have built your life upon false hopes. People getting saved, right, running away from being infected by HIV and AIDS. That's not salvation.